Hello everyone. In today's video, we are talking about Harlem Renaissance. Harlem Renaissance is a period of remarkable creativity in literature, music, dance, painting, and sculpture by African Americans. From the end of the First World War in 1917 till 1937, it is considered as most influential movement in African American literary history. The purpose of participants was to make their people aware of richness of their own culture and art form, and to redefine the Negro, who until now was looked at only from the white's perspective. And now they stood to redefine racial pride. In defense of widespread prejudice and discrimination against many like them. It was in 1920s that creative and intellectual life flourished within African American communities in the North and Midwest regions of the United States in Harlem, the New York City neighborhood, which was spread only 3 square miles. Teamed with black artists, intellectuals, writers, musicians, and many more, as well as some of the era's most important literary and artistic figures. Through their experiment in the field of literature, music, theater, and visual arts, they tried to break away from the white racist tradition and embrace the black modes and manners as they were the aspects of African heritage in which they had started to take pride. Though there was not a particular school of thought that dominated this movement, it succeeded to influence the future. The movement laid the groundwork for all later African American literature and had an enormous impact on subsequent black literature and consciousness worldwide. Coming to the origin, it seems that origin of the Harlem Renaissance lies in the great migration of the early 20th century, when hundreds of thousands of black people migrated from the South into dense urban North areas that offered relatively more economic opportunities and cultural capital. This brought many positive changes in their lives, thereby leading to the change of their traditional image as an illiterate, ignorant, and a secondary human being. They even acquired a sizable chunk of real estate in the heart of Manhattan, which allowed a large number of blacks to come and get settled there. It created opportunities for the black intellectuals to have regular fruitful interaction and expand their contacts internationally. This made dramatically rising levels of literacy, creation of national organizations, decided to pressing African-American civil rights, uplifting the race, and opening socio-economic opportunities, and developing race pride, including Pan-African sensibilities and programs. The editor, journalist, and critic Ellen Locke called it a spiritual coming of age for African-American artists and thinkers who seized upon their first chances for group expression and self-determination. So it is true that African-American writers of this period have very skillfully handled all these genres of literature and proved themselves to be far superior to their white counterparts. The Harlem Renaissance poets such as Langston Hughes, Claude McKay, and Georgia Dolgus Johnson explored the beauty and pain of black life and sought to define themselves and their community outside of white stereotypes. Poetry from the Harlem Renaissance reflected a diversity of forms and subjects. Some poets, such as Claude McKay, used culturally European forms. The sonnet was one, melted with the radical message of resistance, as in, "If we must die." Others, including James Weldon Johnson and Langston Hughes, brought specifically black cultural creations into their work, infusing their poems with the rhythms of ragtime, jazz, and blues. The other note-taking writers are the novelist Jean Toomer, Jesse Fawcett, and Wallace Thurman. Many essayists, memoirists, and writers in diverse modes such as James Weldon Johnson, Marcus Garvey, and Anna Bonstam, etc. And these are the works associated with the Harlem Renaissance, like Blackbirds of 1928, Encyclopedia of the Harlem Renaissance, The New Negro, The Life of Ellen Locke, Shuffle Along, Musical, Untitled, The Birth, Painting, Voodoo, which is an opera, When Washington Was in Vogue, The Negro in Art, Taboo, 1922 Play, There Will Be Some Changes Made, and many more. Now, we are in the position to say that it was during this period the African American realized the greatness of their art and culture and started to express themselves in whatever form they liked. However, this was also a period of transition for them as they suffered from the agonies of split identity. On the one hand, they were Americans living in the country for centuries, and on the other, they were Negroes who were not allowed to be one with the national identity. On this, W.E.B. Du Bois suggested that blacks in America lacks a true self-consciousness. They suffer from a double consciousness, which Du Bois defines as a sense of always looking at oneself through the eyes of the others. He writes, "One never feels his two-ness, an American, a Negro. Two souls, two thoughts, two unreconciled stringings, two warning ideals in one dark body, whose dogged strength alone keeps it from being torn apart." And therefore we see the writers of Harlem came forth and explored various techniques through their works that dealt with certain common themes like alienation, marginality, the use of folk material, the use of blues tradition, and the problem of writing from an elite audience. These writers show that Harlem Renaissance was not merely a literary movement. It had other issues that were closely related to the Negroes and their arts. These issues included racial consciousness, the Black to Africa movement, racial integration, the explosion of music, painting, and dramatic revues. Until now, African American and their works were treated as substandard and were also looked down upon by the mainstream white writers. However, the Harlem Renaissance gave the black experience its distinct identity and permanently reserved its place in the history of American literature. One of the most important features of Harlem Renaissance was that it had deep roots in the history and culture, though there were also attempts to move away from the old and create a new. It was strongly believed that the art and literature are the agent of change, and they will lead to the betterment of America herself. However, this idea was shaken with the sudden arrival of Great Depression. As many of you might not know that, the Great Depression was a severe worldwide economic depression, means economic downfall, that took place during the 1930s, with its beginning in United States. So, because of the Great Depression, the faith of African Americans in democratic reform changed into horrors of disbelief. Those who strongly believed that these reforms would bring them positive results were completely disappointed by the way things took turn. As the intellectuals naively believed that culture is the center of every human activity and it cannot be affected by the economic and social realities. But these assumptions were turned into frustrations. They were taken aback by the cruel repercussion of the Great Depression. However, it doesn't mean that the Harlem Renaissance had lost its significance. On the contrary, this Renaissance became a symbol and a point of reference for everyone to recall. Now, it was the name Harlem that became synonymous with new vitality, the black urbanity and black militancy. It became a racial focal point for blacks the world over. It remained for a time a race capital. In this connection, Ellen Locke has rightly remarked that the peasants, the student, the businessman, the professional man, artist, poet, musician, adventurer and worker, preacher and criminal, exploitator and social outcast, each group has come with its own special motives, but their greatest experience has been the finding of one another. The living together in the urban area of Harlem, a large number of Negroes had come there from different places and backgrounds with their peculiar experiences, allowed the black artists to understand real complexities of the lives of the people. This urban setting helped them to share each other's experiences, which led to the birth of much needed race consciousness amongst them. A close study of this movement shows that the legacy of Harlem Renaissance is limited by the character of the Renaissance. There has been an encouragement to the new appreciation of folk roots and culture. Peasant folk materials and spirituals provided a rich source for racial imagination, and it freed the blacks from the establishment of past condition. But Harlem Renaissance was imprisoned by its own innocence. The Harlem intellectuals, while proclaiming a new race consciousness, became mimics of whites, wearing clothes and using manners of sophisticated whites, from the very people they were supposed to be championing. Unfortunately, the movement of Harlem Renaissance failed to overcome the overwhelming white presence in commerce, which defined art and culture. The followers of this movement could not realize that there was a need to reject white values. They had to see whites without awe of love or awe of hate, and themselves truly, without myth or fantasy, in order that they could be themselves in life and art. But it can be said that Harlem Renaissance undoubtedly created an ethnic provincialism, and its biggest gift could be a lesson from its failures. It is observed that this movement tried to separate the blacks from the American culture. However, the fact was most of the blacks were Native Americans. It led to the negative implications as the black, unlike the other immigrants, had no immediate past and history and culture to celebrate. But the positive implication of American nativity had never been fully appreciated by them. It seems too simple. The Afro-American history and culture is American, more completely so than most others in the country. It seems that the 1920s was too early a period for the blacks to have felt the certainty about native culture that would have freed them from crippling self-doubt. That is why the art of Renaissance was so problematic, freckless, not fresh, not real. However, it leaves us the true black Renaissance awaits Afro-Americans claiming their patria, their nativity. With this, let's end today's video. I really appreciate each one of you for your patient listening. Thank you.